is learning, and he is actually thriving in this virtual environment.
Feedback from parents on the virtual Knox County Schools plan vary, and early emails between Knox County school leaders show the system's expectations varied as well. Here's 10 News reporter Gabrielle Hayes with more on the exchanges and what we've learned from parents.
It's no secret the virtual program has been smooth for some and rather difficult for others. But the difficulties between virtual school and the Quest program added an extra layer for parents. Email exchanges between the Board of Education and the superintendent show the system only anticipated half the current number of virtual students. Its goal, no more than 2,000 total for its virtual Quest program, which is partly asynchronous, meaning not all of it is in real time with a teacher, and some content is recorded. System leaders initially told WBIR it was intended for high school students. However, in an email, KCS confirmed 800 elementary students are enrolled in Quest. We are still waiting to find out the total number. Back in August, we interviewed Brian DeGraff, who's sixth grader, who has an IEP, was enrolled in Quest. He later got him pulled out.
The 3.5 days that my son spent in Quest were very frustrating. We were trying our best to work through the online learning modules.
However, Jackie Romo says her fourth grader is having a good experience.
My son absolutely is loving it. He's doing better with his grades than he ever was.
Though there are varying opinions in how Quest is going for virtual students, it's clear there will be more questions about how it will roll out in the spring semester. In Knoxville, Gabrielle Hayes reporting.